Hi, in this video we're going to be talking about the CO screw adjustment again. Let it be something like a part 2 of my video, because there are some people, some of you that didn't quite manage to understand what I wanted to say in that video. So in this video I will try to, correct myself. One more thing. I would appeal to you to watch my videos to the end. I make videos that way that you have to follow it from the beginning to the end. And that I must say, each of my videos is watched in average time of 30%. So if my video lasts for 12 minutes, it's watched for 3 minutes. Or maybe for 7 minutes, the last one was 7 minutes long and it was watched in average for 3 minutes. Well, please watch these videos from the beginning till the end. I make the videos that way, that you have to follow it and not to skip just. Watch a bit for a minute, then skip, then watch again, skip again. Well, if you want to learn something about the Ke-Jetronic, this is how you will have to do that, by carefully listening to what I'm telling you. And for all of those that didn't manage to understand what I wanted to say in that video, then let's watch this video, shall we? Let's watch key moments in the video, afterwards I will explain in more details. You must get a free play between 1 and 3 mils. The ideal would be 1.9. Look, we have a little gap here before the plunger starts moving harder. Clockwise, we make the mixture richer. Counterclockwise, we make it leaner. So, the more you turn this screw clockwise, this plate is going to become stiff. Look, how can you know how much it would be 1.9 mils? Use your caliper. And we want now to measure the distance between this and between the sensor plate. So we put it just like this to touch the sensor plate, and that's 27.8. And now we're going to add 1.9 on this 27.8. There you have it. And now look, what do we do now? As I use my caliper here, as I touch like this, from here the sensor plate must start sliding harder. Now, once again, with proper explanation, you must get a free play between 1 and 3 mils. The ideal would be 1.9. At the very beginning, I must stress, this procedure is done with the engine off. Look, we have a little gap here before the plunger starts moving harder. Clockwise, we make the mixture richer. counterclockwise, we make it leaner. So, the more you turn this screw clockwise, this plate is going to become stiff. Look. How can you know how much it would be 1.9 mils? Use your caliper. And we want now to measure the distance between this and between the sensor plate. Important is the distance to the sensor plate. So we put it just like this to touch the sensor plate, and that's 27.8. I got 27.8 mils. This doesn't mean that you have to get the same distance as I got. And now we're going to add 1.9 on this 27.8. There you have it. Just measure with the caliper the distance to the sensor plate, and then add 1.9 mils. So from that point, the sensor plate must start moving harder. And now, look, what do we do now? As I use my caliper, here, as I touch like this, from here, the sensor plate must start sliding harder. Now, let's do everything in real time. So let's do it. Look. Here, I have that gap I need. And now, I'm going to take my 3 mils wrench, and then here, now, I'm going to make the mixture rich by purpose, because I want the sensor plate to move hard. Look. Here. This should be enough. I think this is enough. Here. We have no play. No free gap. And now, what's important? The important thing is that there is no data that how much this distance should be. Just take a caliper and measure this distance from this part here up to the weight. A bit more. Here. There. And here. How much did I get? 26, 7, 8, 28.4. Do you see? Now I got 28.4. And now I have to add 28.4. And now I have to add on this 28.4, 1.9. And that's 28.3. So look, now as I press with a caliper, you see? You see what I'm doing? From this position, The sensor plate must start moving harder. And this is that play. This is that free gap we have to get. But as you see, look. We have none. So we take our 3 mm wrench. We stick it here. And now we have to move it counterclockwise. For how much? I don't know. We're gonna see now. Here. This was for half a turn. Did we get something? No, we got nothing. Let's do it more. It's one turn. Let it be two turns for now. Here, I'm starting to get that gap. Just a bit, do you see? Just a bit. Well, I have to hold it like this to simulate real conditions. Here. One more. Nothing more. Okay. One more. So, I made two turns. Here, look. Look at this now. Look at how much gap I have now. Do you see that? And this is for sure more than 1.9. Let's see that. You see? Here, do you see that? So now we have to go clockwise. You see, this is too much. This is about 5 mm. Oops. Let's go for one turn. Here, it's less. Let's see. This is how you have to do that. Here, do you see? Okay, I must hold this thing, the distributor, like this. You see? It's really hard. A bit less. Wow. Here, just here, something like this. Oh God. Now it seems to be too much. No, no, no. Quite on the contrary. You see? Let's make it richer. A bit more. Here. Where is it? I think I got it. Here. Something like this. I think I got it. Do you see now? Okay, now let's try to check it. It's a bit difficult. Here, I think I got it. Because, you know, I don't have the screw and I have to simulate it now with my finger. You see? There. I think I got it. That's it. So my dear ones, if you enjoyed this video, then please don't click the button skip ad. It is going to help me a lot. And till the next video, happy Mercedesing.